ex-Catholic priest is snatched to hell and heaven. The year 2003, I am bishop of the Evangelical Church Sons of Faith. Before becoming a Christian, I was a priest of the Roman Catholic Church. I celebrated the seven sacraments as Catholic baptism, confirmation, Eucharist, penance, anointing of the sick with oil, Catholic marriages and holy orders. I baptized newborn children and loved pictures. I used holy water, candle, salt, anointed cloth and sacred objects. I wore the cassock and the consecrated host. I had the episcopate to teach and I adored Mary. For me, she was the Mother of God, Mother of the Church, Mediatrix, Queen of Heaven, C.O. Redemptrix and Immaculate Conception. I was a devotee of Mary and consecrated everything to her and prayed her prayers. For me, she was divine, a perpetual virgin and a goddess. My childhood friend Carlos from the born-again Pentecostal Church told me about the idolatry of images and unmasked the dogmas of the Catholic Church. He proved in the Bible that everything I learned had no biblical basis. I began to be discouraged from being a priest. I had fallen into fornication because of the priest's office that forbade marriage. I had no hope of marrying and having children, forming a family. Brother Carlos has proved that marriage is lawful for the pastorate. I had fallen into fornication with a woman named Belita while still a father. Today she is my wife. I began to hide this love affair from the bishops and archbishops. I did not want to tarnish my reputation. Finally, I got tired of hiding this secret and left the cassock and went to live with my wife Belita. I married her and went to congregate in the evangelical church that does not prohibit the marriages of the leaders. I discovered that I had lived in the deception of the Catholic Church. For me, Jesus Christ did not have so much power to save a soul. I always trusted Mary to intercede for my salvation and I still asked for all the saints to pray for me to be rescued from hell. When I prayed to Jesus to protect me, I made several prayers to all the saints. I discovered all the deceitfulness of these teachings, which I was instructed. I wept in repentance and did a whole night of prayer. As a result, a resplendent and shining angel appeared. I was amazed by his splendor and glory. I was speechless, looking at that glory that came out of him. The angel of the Lord said, "There is an ideological spiritual warfare agent to deceive the elect in these last days. There have never been as many false sects and churches as you are having in these end times. Things are getting worse and Satan has gained many souls with his evil mental ideologies. He has implanted his lies through sects, philosophies, movies, fake gospel, novels, drawings and all kinds of music. All this has marked human minds with the deceit that takes away the faith from the gospel. The servants of Satan have been saying that Jesus is a myth and does not exist. They have not valued the power of redemption in the scriptures. They say the Bible is just a history book, making people's faith not work. What makes the scripture different from any other book is faith. The faith of life is the word that will produce eternal life for those who believe. Satan knows the power of the word to deliver and save. He uses his sectarian philosophies to combat the scriptures in order to take attention from the word of God. Jesus sent a message to you. He wants you to open a ministry and bring all the Catholics you used to teach when you were a father. They still trust you, despite being a Christian." The angel disappeared and left that day. My plans to open a church was put into action. When I inaugurated my church and invited all Catholics, I could win 70% of the people who came to join me when I was a priest. Now I taught the true word and turned the Catholic people into believers. They were now workers in the sheepfold. After I saw the angel, my faith increased. I knew I was not alone and that the celestial beings are more real than my body. Now I had reason to challenge Satan. I was no longer afraid of insults and persecutions. I was praying without ceasing on the hill and it was already late at night. I began to feel an electric discharge of anointing. Something supernatural began to happen on that mountain. The Holy Spirit took my mouth and began to speak in a spiritual language. I could not stop talking. I was taken with great power, and a plant began to burn and burned with fire, but it was not consumed in that mountain. The plant remained intact. My body was paralyzed and I did not resist the power of God that took my soul. I fell to the ground and Jesus appeared to me on that hill. He was very bright. I could only see Jesus with great difficulty. That was real. My spirit was before the presence of Jesus, I saw him for real, plus my body was lying on the ground. Jesus called me to go to a place, I was happy and I thought it would be heaven. He started walking down with me through a deep hole, and the more we walked down, the darker it became. Upon reaching the floor of that place, I felt an unbearable stench of rotting flesh. I was terrified to see demons eating people's flesh. They fed by ripping out the brains and viscera, they make cruelties to souls by plucking arms, legs and head to feed themselves, and the stench of carrion flooded that place. I asked Jesus, who was by my side, the reason for that stench if they are not meats, but lost spirits. Jesus said that it is the sins they carry with them. Sin stinks in hell when your soul was not cleansed by the blood of Jesus. When people reached hell, the worms begin to rise from within their souls. The filthy soul sprouts worms that causes the rot and stink. The spirit upon reaching hell is sliced like meats by the butcher. In hell, things become real as on earth. There the spirit bleeds and has bones. Hell is a real place equal to the earth. All kinds of death, violence, carnage, and prostitution on earth also exist in hell. The earth is only a shadow of the evil that happens in hell. The demons rape the souls and cut them. They force souls to engage in sex by force. Souls are tormented through intimate parts. Everything you do on earth will continue to be done in hell. That which is planted in life will be gathered into eternity. A killer can kill over 100 people on earth. He will never pay for those lives while on earth. Even if he is arrested, the law of man is not enough to take away his evil deeds. But when he dies, in eternity the spiritual law will be applied in his soul with righteousness. The law of man on earth is unjust, but the divine law is the consuming fire of divine wrath. While in hell came a man who had murdered more than 20 people. He had never been arrested because the justice of the earth could not unravel the crime and reach that man. He died with debt in righteousness, but he cannot escape from the fire of hell. The fire ignited when it burned this man. He had a lot of sin that fueled that fire. The place where this man was isolated turned into a sea of fire. The darkness of that place is dense. The climate is negative. There is no oxygen there. There is no life, no trees, and no grass. There is no water and no wind breeze. The animals I saw in hell are strange and devour people. The people do not die despite being torn by these infernal beasts. Several carnivorous insects eat people's flesh. Terrible insects like beetles devouring souls. They enter all parts of the body. These insects penetrated through the flesh and entered the body. Others entered through the mouth, nose, ear, and eyes. The more violent ones pierced the belly, the back, and the skull to enter. The worms that sprouted inside people's interiors and consumed it from the inside out until it reached the skin. The worms were insatiable and in a few minutes devoured the souls, leaving the skeletons. Poisonous snakes stung people and ejaculated poisons from their prey. These snakes punished souls with various bites, punishing them for committing repulsive sins when they were alive on earth. Anacondas wound on the bodies of souls and crushed them. I could hear the sound of breaking bones. When I was a Catholic, I believed in purgatory to purify souls, but now, I know purgatory does not exist. Wake up, Catholic people, do not let Satan fool you. Do not put the hope of dying and going to purgatory to get a second chance. You think you will go to purgatory and then go to heaven. There is no second chance if you died in your sins. You go to hell directly without going through purgatory, and if you fall in there it will be too late. There is no way out there. The door to hell is locked. The gate of hell opens to receive the souls and everything is locked so that none could escape. Souls cannot get out of that torment. If you do not believe me and prefer to live in sin, one day you will die and you will remember this testimony. You do not want to regret it when you fall inside. All this torment I've seen in hell. If you go there you'll see everything I've seen, but it will be too late for you. The demons shall cast you into the fire even as you cast a stone into the sea. I saw in hell the worshippers of Mary and the Catholic saints, the worshippers of Saint Peter, Saint Paul, Saint John and the other saints are there. I have seen priests, archbishops and Catholic bishops in hell. I saw nuns, mothers, altar boys and popes in hell. The demons tortured these souls by sticking them with spears. They also drilled with drills by making deep holes in their bodies. The demons used knives to cut and slice the souls. I saw when a demon got a meat grinder and put the souls inside that machine. When the souls left the crusher, they looked like ground meat. On the other side of hell, the demons were with chainsaws. They sawed the souls to pieces. On earth, not even the worst horror film compares to those sufferings. I also saw demons making orgies and infernal debaucheries with souls. They raped homosexual prostitutes and transsexuals. Within a few minutes, a sea of fireworms came like a tsunami and covered the whole place. A tide of fire flames took that place, causing a strong smell of burnt flesh. Tears fell from Jesus' eyes. He does not take pleasure in seeing the suffering souls. People who choose their ways, forgetting the one who can offer eternal life. It's hard for Jesus to see those sufferings. He just went to hell to show me the situation of souls so that I may report on earth and prevent more souls from getting lost. That place smells death and fear. It is a place of shouting, groans, sweat, blood, tears, gnashing of teeth and all sorts of suffering. And then Jesus took me to another place in hell. A giant metal plate was written like this: "Welcome celebrities and have a great reception." As I passed the metal plate door, I saw singers, actors, and many celebrities there. I saw a famous band signs in that place. I only recognized two rockers and an actress. I saw rocker Bill Haley jumping frenetically because of the flames that consumed him. Guitarist Jimi Hendrix was crying in pain. He felt very thirsty and hungry in that place. The demons made him play the guitar of fire until his fingers fell. Many Satanist rockers who had made covenants are now being tormented by the demons. I saw the actress Thay Trang, who participated in the Power Ranger series. When she saw Jesus, she cried out to take her away. All these celebrities are in hell because of fame and money. The covenants they made with the devil brought them to this place. It's sad to see many actors, actresses, and filmmakers in that place. Many of these celebrities I did not know. The path of all who desire recognition and money is hell. They are dead on earth and forgotten, but alive in hell. They suffer various kinds of sufferings. It's sad to see the scary scenes on their faces. There is nothing on earth as terrifying as this place. The scenes of the mutilations of souls are a horror. I witnessed with my eyes a real horror movie. Jesus took me out of hell and we climbed up to earth together. When I was a priest, I had an affair with my wife. We still had not made a commitment because I was a priest. My son Jorge was born at that time. I had hidden this secret from the Catholic bishops for 2 years. When I became a Christian, I married my wife and congregated in a church. I raised a family and I had another child, a girl whose name is Claire. She came to be born when my son Carlos was already 11 years old. When my son turned 15, I bought a gift watch. He helped me a lot in the work and was my only son. I had already founded my ministry and Carlos helped me when he was by my side. One day he was coming from school and was robbed. The boy who assaulted him shot him in the chest and stole my son's watch. He died at the time. I felt a lot of pain with the death of Carlos. The demons were very angry that I went to hell and witnessed what I saw. They tried to reach me by touching on what I loved the most, my wife and my children, but I stood firm. I did not murmur against God, because He gives His life to those who serve Him from the heart. He does not take the life of a teenager who is dedicated to his work. The devil came to kill, steal and destroy. A year and a few months later, I found out who my son's murderer was. I approached him to learn the reason for the murder. He did not know that I was Carlos's father. This young man calls himself Oscar. He is very poor and wanted my son's watch to sell. I understood his need to steal his watch, but it did not please me to have taken my treasure from me. Young Oscar was 20 years old. I wanted to hand him over to the authorities, but I had no concrete evidence to incriminate him. The young man did not know the reason for my approaching him. He regarded me as his friend. The Holy Spirit told me, "Preach the word to him." I resisted his voice and questioned in my prayer. I said, "He's my son's killer that I loved. He took away my only son, a fellow man. He is no better than any murderer I've seen in hell and deserves the same destination." I went to bed and an angel appeared to me. He pointed his finger in my direction at the height of my nose. He pulled my spirit through my nostrils. My spirit stayed with the angel, he went up with me to the clouds, the angel showed the planet to me, the earth was vibrating its rotation and spinning at high speed and accelerated greatly. The angel said, "The vibrations and rotations of the earth are getting faster and faster. The days of the earth are being shortened, the years will pass in a hurry." The angel showed me the days of tribulation. A man of great religious importance made a sacrifice for Satan to release the demons. Satan receives strength through these sacrifices and opens the pit of hell. An army of demons invades the earth to execute judgment on sinner. People became crazy, unbalanced, oppressed, and possessed by demons. They were tormented and incurable wounds grew all over. There were fearful deadly diseases that did not kill people. These people took on the form of zombies and suffered great mental control. They were slaves of the government. I looked at the river Euphrates. Four angels were liberated and destroyed a great part of the world population with wars, diseases, and hunger, and along with these principalities, millions of soldiers from hell were released to destroy mankind. All the people and Jews that had no seal of God were decimated. The hordes of hell marched against the earth and caused destruction. Men possessed by demons became killing machines. Nuclear weapons were thrown into the earth and caused great destruction. Millions of people and the Hebrews were killed on this earth. Those who had the mark on their foreheads persecuted the Christians. The wrath of God has fallen from heaven upon thieves, sorcerers, murderers, and prostitutes. The rulers with the Antichrist could not rule. All was in chaos and destruction. The angel showed me the names of denominations involved in the ministry of salvation. Some churches managed 50% of souls saved, while others reached 40% and 30%, churches that had no commitment 20% and 10%, while corrupt churches at 5% and 2%. The smaller and unknown churches reached a higher percentage of salvation, and the great churches reached a lower percentage of salvation. The angel said, "The more people there are in the churches, the more they grow financially and the more fearful they become of preaching salvation. I and the angel and we enter paradise. It is a beautiful, flourishing place with great castles for the church to live in. All were of fine gold of a great splendor that shines like a sun in that place." The angel pointed his finger at a crowd of people. He said, "Look at your son Carlos." I looked and saw that they all looked the same. The angel opened my spiritual eyes and I recognized my son. He was different, happy and very joyful. The angel allowed me to meet my son. I gave him a very strong hug and said, "I love you," the hug he'd never given when he was on earth. I overcame my son to walk in holiness. I did not want to lay a hand on his head with that fear of losing to the world. A hug in my thinking could make you relax. I missed giving my son more love. Too bad that many remember loving when they lose their loved ones. Love your family, love your children, love your parents and grandparents, enjoy the best moments and do something for your parents and grandparents while they are alive. After they die, it's no use regretting what they might have done. I have seen a golden book full of hidden mysteries that have not yet been revealed. The angel said that the Bible is essential to save mankind, but not all the mysteries of God are contained in the Bible. There are books in heaven that are written things that are beyond our thoughts. Before we were born, Jesus had drawn up a plan for every faithful servant. Jesus has not put all your secrets in the Bible so that we will come to God and pray we will have revelations. The angel said, "The young Oscar who murdered your son is a chosen person for a great work. Satan was struggling to take that soul." The angel revealed that through him many souls will be saved. The angel said, "If you do not preach the gospel to him, no one else will speak. His salvation is in your hands. If you do not preach the word, he will die and go to hell. You will account for his blood and be responsible for all the souls this young man could have gained if he were a Christian. Everything you do in the material world is reflected in the spiritual world. If you win the soul of this young man, multitudes of people will be saved through him. If you let him die, this crowd of people will not convert and they will go to hell." The angel showed me in a vision how it would be if young Oscar became a Christian. He had a Bible in his hand and talked about Jesus. A large crowd heard his message. He was pastor of a great church. My mind understood that this young man is important in the work of God. The angel showed me this young man on earth, and at that moment he was in danger of death. The devils gathered to reap his life before he was converted. The demons had a great sense of God's work in this life. The danger to the demons of losing that soul was my approach to this young man. I asked the angel why my son was allowed to die. The angel showed me a future vision. My son was in the vision and he was 18 years old. It had been 3 years later. He died at the age of 15. My son in the vision grew cold in the faith and decided to live his own life. He abandoned Jesus' path and got involved with drinks and drugs. He became involved with a girl he met in the underworld of addictions, and because of jealousy, he was possessed by a demon. He murdered his girlfriend with a knife and awoke with the body. Soon after, he was murdered by this girl's brother. I did not recognize my son, because in the future vision he was someone else. Satan had changed his personality. The angel said, if he lived here 3 years later, he would be someone who would bring a lot of pain to his parents, and he would still go to hell. God allowed him to die in a state of his purity. The moment he most sought God with all his heart, this was the best moment of his life. Satan was already planning to corrupt his life. There I understood how God works. Sometimes I question God that he was wrong to allow an event. God knows all things and we know nothing. If he allows the death of a loved one, God knows what he is doing. My son, if he lived another 3 years, would be in hell, and God would be just to send my son to the torment. I asked the angel because my salary is little, I wanted a raise and a lot of prosperity. The angel answered me, Michael, your heart is not prepared to receive earthly conquests. Any material possessions of high value would be a barrier between you and Jesus. This would contribute to your turning away from the path of salvation, which further would give something that would harm his son. So is our God. There are blessings matters that lead you to spiritual death, blessings that will cause your spiritual life to commit suicide and be cast into hell. You asked for a financial blessing that will kill you. This blessing, if you receive it now, will kill your spiritual life. Your heart still desires the things of this earth, which makes it dangerous for you to receive. When you are prepared spiritually, you will receive. God knows your heart. When the desire to have material things dies within you to the point of never again caring for the things of the earth, God will give you everything you want. But when that time comes, it will not make any difference to you. When the things of the flesh are born of the spirit, there will be no negative action upon your life. I understood what the angel said. Now I understand why many Christians who make many prayer campaigns have not yet received their blessings, and only after years do they receive. Others do not persevere and deviate because of it. When it comes to material things, it takes time. Everything that is part of this world is dangerous. God gives blessings and will never deny his children, but everything has the right moment. The secret is, the more spiritual you are, the more material things you will be blessed with. As long as the heart is trapped in the things of the earth, the blessing will be delayed. The angel sent me back to earth. The heartache that I had in my heart was plucked by the angel. The angel took away the hurt in my heart. His hand entered my chest and pulled black mud from inside my heart. If you keep anger in your heart because of a person who made you suffer, you will not be saved. Pray to God and forget it. Ask him to heal your heart. Nurturing anger in the heart condemns people and leads them to hell. In the torment is full of people with a heart full of rancor. I went to preach the gospel to the young man who murdered my son, and I also said that the boy he killed is my son. That young man became nervous and thought I would report him. I calmed down the boy and said that I have forgiven him for his crime. The young man cried because he did not expect my attitude of love. Despite having killed my son, the young man asked me for forgiveness. He turned and bowed his knee, giving his life to Jesus. My love attitude caused more impact than 1,000 words. That young man became a worker in my church. In 1 year God raised this man and he was never again the same. He was ashamed of his past and lamented for having caused pain in me that I was his shepherd. He helped me in the work and tried to fill the vacancy that my son left in the family. I told him that he does not have to sacrifice himself by wanting to fix something that will never be solved. I told him to stay in peace and worry about the work of God. He said goodbye to me and went to do the work in a distant country, and we never saw each other again. Another fact that happened was with a missionary friend. He traveled through Latin America until one day his plane crashed. I question God that he allowed the missionary to die. Jesus appeared to me. I was praying at night when I was visited. He said, "Everyone on the plane went to hell, but my servant is here with me. Do not worry about him. He's in a better place than you. Worry about the lost souls that still live." Jesus showed me a circle, and inside it were several people walking. This circle is planet Earth, and crowds of people walked through the city. The Lord said, "Son, these people do not know the way that walks. They look like lost children, orphans without parents. I love them all. They are my creations. Look at these people with my eyes and feel how I feel about them." Jesus touched me. I began to look at those people with a look of love. It was something so strong that it came out of the heart and sprouted from the soul. I felt the love of Jesus inside him for every person on earth. All the love gathered together that parents feel for their children will still not exceed the love of Jesus. Even if you gather all the love of the whole world, it would still be minimal and cannot be compared to the love of Jesus. Jesus said, "Take care of my flock with love and discipline for your good." Jesus disappeared. I have a small message to the people of God, Church of Christ. Try to put some things into practices. Take a day to give alms to a poor or homeless person. Take a day to clean the house of an impious person. Take a day to visit a sick person at the hospital. Take a day to thank God in your prayers and you will feel better. This is a testimony of overcoming that God has given me.